How much importance do we place in the Word of God? Do we appreciate the seriousness of our responsibility to know God's Word? God said, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge," in Hosea chapter 4 and verse 6. And there are many passages we can read which show the importance of knowing God's Word. Today, I'd like for us to notice one such passage that shows the importance of God's Word and the results of being without it. It comes to us from the Old Testament prophet Amos in the 8th chapter of his book, beginning in verse 11. He says, "Behold, days are coming, declares the Lord God, when I will send a famine on the land. Not a famine for bread or a thirst for water, but rather for hearing the words of the Lord. People will stagger from sea to sea and from the north even to the east. They will go to and fro to seek the word of the Lord, but they will not find it. In that day the beautiful virgins and the young men will faint from thirst. As for those who swear by the guilt of Samaria, who say, 'As your God lives, O Dan, and as the way of Beersheba lives,' they will fall and not rise again." This passage begins with a parallel between the Word of God and food in order to make the point that His Word sustains us in our spiritual life in the same way that food sustains us in our physical life. This comparison is also made in the New Testament when the Word of God is referred to as milk and solid food or meat. Those passages teach that the Word of God is designed to cause us to grow and mature as Christians. Other passages also show the importance of the Word of God. Without the words of Christ, we cannot obtain eternal life, according to John 6 and verse 68. Also, without the gospel, we cannot be saved, for it is the power of God unto salvation, Romans 1 and verse 16. In the same way that food nourishes us physically, God's Word nourishes us spiritually. A spiritual famine, though, works like a physical famine. The effects are ones that are quite slow. When a famine arises, people do not perish immediately. Instead, they get weaker and weaker over time until they are no longer able to survive. But the fault for this spiritual famine lies with man and not with God. God has given us His Word for our spiritual survival. But man can choose to reject it, neglect it, or they may simply not know it. When we fail to take advantage of the Word that God has revealed to us, we will perish, and we will not be able to blame Him for this. But sadly, despite the great importance of the Bible, many preachers today neglect to speak as the oracles of God, 1 Peter 4 and verse 11. And what's even sadder is that many churches allow this to take place. But how do preachers know what to preach? Friends, they are to preach what is found in God's Word. When Paul wrote to the Romans, he said that he was eager to preach the gospel to them. But why was he eager? Well, the next verse tells us, "The gospel is the power of God unto salvation." Now, friends, there will be consequences for the negligence of preachers and teachers to proclaim the whole Word of God, and for Christians also allowing it and not knowing the Bible for themselves. Therefore, as we consider the things that we're taught, we consider the books that we read, the articles that are presented to us, we listen to the lessons that are presented over the radio or in the pulpit, or in the Bible classroom, or even in our homes. We listen to those things that are proclaimed, and we compare the things that are said with what God's Word teaches. And if the things that we are being taught is contrary to what God's Word teaches, then another gospel is being taught. And the Scriptures tell us that if anyone comes along and proclaims another gospel unto you, other than that which you have been taught, meaning that which is contained in God's Word, then you are not to give that person any attention. You are to consider that person as if they are a curse. You're not to give them any of your attention, nor to consider the things that they are teaching, because it stands in opposition to the truth of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Friends, we thank you for joining us for our program today, and have a blessed day.